ready to say no to a Trump agenda of ripping health care away from our fellow Virginians. Declining Planned Parenthood will reverse all the progress we made on climate change. And are you ready to make David Toscano the next Speaker of the House of Delegates? I want to thank you for everything you do to help get Democrats elected year in and year out. Everything that you've done to help me over the years. And Susan and Jean, I want to thank you for your campaigns. You all ran amazing races that you should be proud of, and that we all are proud of. And Tom, thank you for your campaign, your energy, your passion, your This November, the eyes of the nation and the world are going to be on the Commonwealth. And we have an opportunity to send a clear message about who we are and what we value. We are a Commonwealth where opportunities and your success are limited only by your imagination and your willingness to work hard for it and make it a reality. We're a Commonwealth that values and believes that every child has the right to grow up in a safe and supportive community. And we're a Commonwealth that looks out for those who truly need the arm and shield of the law to help and protect them. Virginia Democrats, our party is united. The other side is divided. And we are poised to make history again in November. When I see a problem, I want to fix it. When I see a wrong, I want to set it right. And I love helping people. And that's why, to me, there is no better a more important job than being Virginia's Attorney General. My team and I have led the charge on the state's response to the heroin and opioid epidemic that is touching the lives of so many families around the Commonwealth. And we have been relentless in going after the traffickers who profit off addiction, but we have coupled that with innovative education and prevention programs and encourage greater investment for recovery and treatment. We've led a transformation in the way Virginia responds to sexual and domestic violence. When I came into office, there were some 2,000 untested sexual assault kits on evidence shelves collecting dust around the state. Now we are in the middle of a $3.4 million program to totally eliminate that backlog. Aggressively defended the rights of taxpayers and seniors, veterans and military families, and secured $100 million in debt relief for veterans and military families who were taken advantage of. This fall, we are going to see a stark contrast in the choice before the voters on who the next Attorney General is going to be. Some of you may know that earlier today, my opponent and I debated the issues in Virginia Beach. And there are a few things that were pretty clear. First of all, I want to say I could not be prouder to have carried our banner. There are a few things that really stand out. First of all, it's clear that my opponent wants to bring back a culture war mentality straight out of the Ken Cuccinelli playbook. He wants to outlaw abortion in all cases, close women's health centers, limit access to birth control. He even went to the Supreme Court to argue that twice, including in the Hobby Lobby case. He opposes common sense gun safety measures. He thinks marriage equality is made up. He spent a career defending white-collar criminals, protecting big corporations and wealthy CEOs accused of defrauding taxpayers or endangering seniors. And something else he did this morning. He doubled down on his support for Donald Trump's illegal, unconstitutional, and un-American travel ban that I stood up against and took to court and won.